Do you have this problem?
I'll show you how to fix it.
Right, that's a quick explanation of why this happens. So this design, this just pops off, it's actually secured, it sits within there. It's got a horrible, I mean, look at the state of that, it's gross. But it's got a horrible, it's got that sealed around there, which stops the water from leaking out. That bit's fine. This part here, inside there, you've basically got a spring, a ball bearing, and a shaft which it slides in and out. That basically wears and gets distorted and then stops it all from clicking down. Annoyingly, you can actually pull this out and go, yeah, that's working fine. But it's the second you put that top on, it doesn't quite reach firm enough down, and that's where you get the problem. So long and short of it, it needs to be replaced and cleaned.
Yeah.
Right, so here you can see we're now under the basin. This is the nut that holds all the gubbins together. I'll show you more detail once I've actually got it out, why in many respects is a bit naff. But first what we've got to do is undo this backing nut here, which releases the trap. This is what's known as a bottle trap. Get a bowl or cloth under there, because there will be water that could potentially spill out there. Not a lot, just enough to make you think I should have put a cloth or a bowl under there. So again, undo this backing up, undo that backing up, and then we'll go top side and pull it all out. See how lovely and clean it looks. All this silicone around here, that all has to come off, cut it off, get a cloth deep down inside, because all this will build up gunky residue, proper gross. And obviously likewise for underneath, all that's got to be nice and clean, so the basin pretty much looks brand new. And obviously I'll explain the difference between this one and the new modern one which I'm going to put in. Right, as you can see, this is the old waste that I just poured out of the basin. Now, one of the big problems with these is, first of all, I've got an internal grill, which is an absolute nightmare to clean. So this is the plastic sill that sits on the underside of the basin. And this is the backing nut that marries up to that sill, which compresses that sill against the basin to stop it from leaking. Now, the biggest problem with that is this backing nut, with most of them, is plastic. So if you tighten up ever so slightly too much, nice little crack going through this backing nut, renders it completely useless, because it doesn't give you enough compression to actually stop water from leaking out. I'm going to show you a unit from Mcalpine. By the way, this is a non-sponsored video. It looks somewhat fiddly, quite a few bits and pieces, but I think it's actually fantastic. Let's open it up. So that's the top part that slides inside the hole. Actually, it's nice and clean. You don't have to screw this down to the base, so you simply pull it up and it's free. You can get this inside the actual waste part itself, and it's nice and clean. But I'll explain more about that in a moment. Now this here, which I find absolutely fantastic, it gives you so many parts. Some of you may not actually need, this is an extended collar. So if your basin's actually narrower, you add it. Or if your basin's quite thick underneath, basically just disregard that. So, but it's you simply get that foam seal, put that on there. You will then have the bottom seal, which then will go onto there. That section will go onto there. This is your bottom seal. It seals up with that, and that simply sandwiches together. Now what holds it all together, if I'm obviously flip over here, you see a screw in there. Now that's metal. You can twist that as much as you want and it shouldn't crack. So that's what makes this better. You can twist it and twist it and twist it until it stops, doesn't crack. The other one, this one here, ever so slightly too much, it's cracked, useless, throw away. So that's what I like about these. And again, with this, there's no internal thread. This thing that simply slides in, clicking this work, causes a problem, pull it out and uses as a normal drainage. But yeah, so I'm going to get on with installing it now. There are a couple of tools that you do need, but I'll show you that in a second. Here's the assembly. Let's pour that out. Put up by the tap for safekeeping. Let's just take these apart now. They're all in front here, so you know what order it needs to be in. So we're going to start with this bit, the top part. That'll go on there, okay? And now go top side. Right, for this part, you'll now need some silicone. So now what we want to do is get the bottom piece, very thin bead. Doesn't matter if you don't even cover it all, just get your finger and just wipe around. Literally, you're making a very like half a mil gasket. You then get one of your seals. That will then go onto that. So your grooves are on the top. Get another thin steed, a bit thicker than the last one, but nonetheless, not too thick. There we are. That's it. I don't need these two bits. My basin's thick. Now, you only really need these if you've got like a metal bowl. So now that, with this on the top side, drop that into place. Marry that from underneath, so it's all nice and lined. Give it a turn. Bring your trap back up, tighten up the backing nut, make sure it's nice and tight. Obviously make sure anything else that has moved is also nice and tight, don't want any movements. And that's it, done. Do a quick test. Make sure it's not leaking, give everything a wipe down. So there we have it. Easy, quick, simple, and trust me, it shouldn't waste too much of your time. If you like this video and the other content I have released, please subscribe and like. I am trying to reach 1,000 subscribers, so please help me on that journey. It's harder than you think it is, so I would really appreciate it if you helped me. See you guys in the next video.